How do you do, sir?
Hi there, ma'am!
Oh, what a lovely dream.
Hey, friend.
Anyone can Hello? Give me, please help me. Please, you, yes, please, a coin, please. Please, won't you lend
it's a all right, boy.
To a fella in need? Coin? Maybe two coins. Whatever you can give, mister.
Fine. Go get yourself something to eat.
Sir, I want you to have this.
Thanks, friend.
It's nice to give something instead of just begging. I hate asking for money like
Howdy.
A goddamn worm. Groveling here in the dirt.
Come on.
Yep.
What's your problem?
Evening.
Yep.
Hey there!
Hello!
Help you with your horse? We've got room in the stable if you need it. If you ain't got the papers, I can't give you the full price. Horses are friendlier than people. They make the most loyal friends. You can tell the difference with these additions. I think you should do it. Goes well with a saddle.
Parker?
You can't have too much with you out in the wilderness.
How you been?
You can tell the difference with these additions. That's a popular one. It's better to equip yourself and not need it than the other way around. You can't have too much with you out in the wilderness. I really think your horse will appreciate it.
Been too many Federals coming through. Might have got some horses.
Thank you, mister. Here, have this for my gratitude. Please.
Appreciate it. Be careful now.
Saint-Denis breeds sickness. So much for the future.
Do. Hey there!
Ah.
Hey there, partner.
Mister?
Okay, settle down there. Hey, mister.
Hello.
Mister, that's terrible.
These days ain't short.
Hey there, miss.
What's wrong with you?
Yeah, alto. Oye.
Don't mind me.
Good morning.
Morning, friend.
There, boy. Good boy. There, boy. That's it, boy. Good boy.
Wait. Come on.
Yep, yep.
Wish my horse looked that bad.
Here.
Slow down!
Hey, you see me there? What do you want from me?
Hey there, mister.
Don?
Hey, mister.
Good day.
Yep.
Morning.
How's that horse doing? I got space for you if you need stabling. I can't give you the full price if you've lost the papers.
Hi there, mister. Hey there, mister. Buddy? Hey, mister.
Morning.
Hey there.
Watch out now.
morning.
Good morning, sir.
Nice around here. I'm kind of new to these parts.
Oh, you know when you have one of those days?
Is that the truth?
How are you, ma'am?
How's everything with you?
Hey, mister. You'll be all right. Okay, boy. Decent town you got here.
That right?
Yeah.
fine morning, sir. Please be careful.
Actually, forget about it. Hey there, partner.
Morning.
Giddy up.
Excuse me, partner.
That's one good looking horse you got there.
Hi there, mister.
Slow up now.
Yep.
Easy.
Partner.
Yeah. Hey, you see that?
You there? Help. You all right? All right, friend, all right. You're gonna be okay.
You gonna help me? I need a doctor. Oh. Please, do something.
Try not to bleed on me.
Oh. Stay awake.
Damn folk.
Buddy?
Where am I?
Don't you give up now.
I'm dying. This is it. My arm. I can't feel it anymore.
Oh, good God. Quickly, bring him in here. Right here, and sit him down in this chair.
Just saw you fall out of the saddle. Don't worry, you're at the doctor.
Thanks, friend. I appreciate it.
Sure.
There's also the matter of my payment. But we'll deal with that later.
All right.
A lot of blood loss. This wound's badly infected. I'll save as much as I can, but I'll have to amputate.
What? What did you say?
Just try to breathe. I'll give you something for the pain. There you are. That'll knock him out for a while. You did a good thing bringing him here. But now, I'd recommend moving along. You do not want to see this. Sorry it's come to this.
Ah, Jesus.
Well, you're in a bad way. But you'll pull through. Nice of you to stay, but don't fret. He'll make it. Come now. Let's let him rest. All we can do now is hope for the best.
Hey, ma'am.
Hello, sir.
His horse, I can tell.
There's something wrong with you.
Thank you.
Are you an idiot?
Your problem.
Hey, friend.
He put the price of the beer up again.
Mister, come on in. First time? Let me know if you have any questions.
Fine cut tobacco products against the far wall, next to the crackers.
A lot more in there than what you see on the shelves.
Order that special for my, wealthier clientele.
Appreciate it. All yours. All right. Tempted? It's a good choice. Enjoy it. Sure, keep looking.
Thanks for your assistance.
Hello, ma'am.
Hey, partner. Hey there.
Hello, sir.
Hey, slow down.
Hey, mister.
Stop.
You got that package. You're coming.
Oh,
hell.
The law will make you pay.
Slow the hell down.
Hello. Mister? Partner?
Hey, partner.
Howdy. Hello, ma'am. Good boy. That's it, boy. Easy, boy. Good boy. There, boy. You're okay, boy.
on, boy. Relax.
Homes for the blind.
Hello, sir.
Oh, is someone there? Hello?
Here you go,
oh,
friend.
Bless you, mister. Truly, you're a saint. Yes, sir, there should be more people in the world like you. God bless.
Hey, mister.
Hello.
Please, can you spare some money for a blind man?
Howdy, mister.
Whole lot of ugly business here.
Hey there!
Watch it! You're crazy! You got a problem?
Let's get...
Safe travel. Remember to rest that horse sometime.
Hey.
Can I help you?
Well, looks like you boys had some trouble.
Yeah, we had some trouble. Bad trouble. What you want?
Oh, I was supposed to meet some business partners here. They arranged a meeting, I believe.
Fellow with a scar and a Mexican?
Yes, sir.
Out by the stables, I think.
Thank you. And, sorry for your troubles, friend.
We're good men, like you.
You don't know me. You turn up in town, you're helping everybody. And there's troubles everywhere. Bandits attack my fields. Men getting killed.
And have you met my partner, Arthur Morgan?
No.
I met your son. Sheriff?
Okay.
Mr. Gray here was saying how he had problems with a family. A family of degenerates.
Oh, well, nobody likes degenerates.
The hag and her inbred sons. They ruined this county. They killed my uncle, you know.
That ain't right.
Problem is, we can't be seen to get too close.
And?
We've got gold, Yankee. We've got gold.
I ain't no Yankee, friend. I ain't nothing. My daddy came over on the boat from Scotland.
I'm Scottish.
And the Braithwaites?
Goddamn peasants. I don't know. Mongrels. Slave fuckers. All you gotta do is look at them.
How much gold?
Enough. These are prized horses I'm talking about. Them, they'll get you 5,000.
5,000 for horses.
Easy.
Where do we sell them, these $5,000 horses?
Over in Clemens Cove. Fellow over there will run them out of state and give you 50 cents on the dollar.
Mister, you got yourself a deal.
Just keep us away from this. Publicly, I mean.
My sense is we keep all horse wrestling away from the public.
Stables on the south side of the manor. That's where they keep the thoroughbred.
crazy old fool?
If he only knew we just torched his tobacco crop.
That was you?
The old man was cursing the Braithwaites about that.
Burning rich folks' property? Sean was like a pig in shit.
I'm sure. 5,000 for horses. They must be rich.
Yeah, he doesn't know what he's talking about. But if we get even a third of that, it'll be worth it.
So how are we gonna play this?
The place is well guarded, so there ain't no point in blasting in there. We'll make them think we're there looking to purchase.
Three armed men?
You'd be armed if you were about to spend 5,000 on horses. We should go in the back way, though. Avoid too many questions.
Tranquilízate. Ha!
Speak to him, okay?
All right, then.
Can I help you, gentlemen?
Yeah, we're here to see about some horses.
Horses?
Yeah, we had an appointment with Mr. Braithwaite, I believe.
Yeah, I never heard about any of this.
Our partner wanted to make a significant investment in some stables down here. But perhaps we should look elsewhere.
Well, okay, then. Head on up to the stables. Someone will come see you.
Ha! Hold.
Thank you.
horses, get paid.
What are you riding off for?
Yeah.
Easy. No need to rush. We don't want to draw any unnecessary attention. I think that's the stables just up ahead. Heads down, play cool. Head around the front. Hitch up there. Coming through.
All right.
All right, let's hitch here. Let me do the talking. Hello there.
Can I help you, boys?
I hope so. Heard you got some horses.
We always got horses.
Fine horses, I mean.
I don't get you, friend.
Yeah, you do. Come on.
Listen, why don't you get out of here? You, Scarface, and your greaser buddy.
Whoa!
I don't like officials.
We ain't officials. We're connoisseurs, looking to do some breedings. Come on now, partner.
Okay, fine. Follow me. These here's mainly the studs available for purchase or for working. If that's what you're interested in. What is your boys interested in?
We represent a famous stable and stud farm from Saratoga.
Is that so?
Unofficially.
Of course. This here's Cerberus. Here you go, boy. Uh-huh, greaser, huh?
Okay. Bandana's on. Don't need no... But he recognizes.
All right, I'll grab the white one in the middle. You get the other two. Relax, boy. Come on.
Good boy.
Hey, easy now.
Easy now.
Easy. You're okay. Marston, you're going to tether him up to Javier's horse.
Okay.
Javier, you're going to lead the stallions. Here. Marston, you ride point. I'll cover up the back. If there's any problems, we'll regroup at Clemens Cove.
Okay.
What are you doing?
Let's go, quick!
Get going, you two!
What the hell are you doing? Stop! Stop! We're being robbed! I said stop these men!
Out of my damn way!
Stay with us, Hunter!
Look out ahead! They're coming out of the fields!
Just over there. Come on. Let's get this over with.
Well, that could have gone smoother.
That'll be on my gravestone. Whoa! You think they look like they're paying $5,000 for horses?
I guess we'll see.
Easy, easy!
What you boys want?
Heard you pay good prices for horses.
Oh, we'll buy more or less anything, Pop.
That so?
Sure, Pop. I'm Clay Davies. That's my brother Clive. We're twins.
John, Arthur, Javier.
So what are you? Cuban?
No.
I don't like Cubans.
That's so?
Maybe. Why, what do you care? You ain't Cuban.
Maybe I like Cubans.
Ooh, you're funny. He's funny. Ain't he funny, Clive? Clive don't talk. We're twins, but I was born first. He came out all yellow and black, but he's okay.
Sure.
Yeah, I know these horses. They ain't yours. But I like you, and I'll give you... I can give you 650 for
them. Okay. I was told we could get up to $5,000 for them.
And I was told the moon was made of ladies' tears. Only it ain't true. Not one little bit.
But...
I like you boys, but I ain't got more than 700 on me. You want it, or you want to ride them fellers into town, and maybe someone there will hang you.
We're gonna need more than that.
I ain't got no more money, Pop. Here, take it or leave it. Uh-huh.
All right.
You goddamn fool, Marston.
Ain't no one around here got $5,000, boys, but nice meeting you. See you boys again, I hope. Come on. Yeah. Close the gate, Clive.
Believed a yarn spun us by one of that Gray family and imagined we was gonna be wonderfully rich. At the end of it, we felt like prize idiots.
How's it going?
What you preparing for?
The greatest of gifts.
An unguarded stagecoach.
No, you simple-minded fool. Bison.
Bison?
Bison, from which you can get anything. There's some over on the plains, I believe. I saw a couple a long way off.
Oh. Good luck.
You want to come with me? I'll show you how we hunt one.
Sure. Why not?
Mount up, then. Let's go. You know, it was before my time, of course, but my mother used to tell me stories of how her tribe moved with the bison. They lived almost as one. Where the bison went, my people went. And they were the center of all life. We couldn't survive without them. They provided us with everything. Food, clothing, shelter, tools. There was a lot of respect.
Huh. I don't remember much of my childhood, but I think my people... Well, we pretty much moved with the whiskey.
Well, my father did that too.
So, where are we headed?
Back up to the Heartlands.
Okay.
Feels like there's been so much noise and chaos recently. Do you mind if we just rode and enjoyed the silence for once? I need to clear my mind.
Sure, fine by me.
Yeah. Not far now. Let's cut up this way. Over there. You see them all? Incredible, aren't they? We should only kill one of them. I'll keep them ringed in and you see if you can bring one down. Okay? Clean as you can.
Okay.
Yep. Take the horns, too. It can all be used. Good job. Stow that on your horse and mount up. Something out.
Okay, let's go. Where are we going?
I thought I saw some scavenger birds over here. Just wanted to see what attracted them. Shot and left for dead, it looks like.
Why would someone do that?
I don't know. But I see tracks heading in this direction. I say we follow them.
All right. Lead the way. Been dead a couple of days, at least.
Shot. I just don't know why anybody would just leave them here to rot like that. Look, another dead bison to our left there. Come on. Shot and left for dead again. But this one looks fresher.
There's a camp there. I'm gonna take a look. Haven't gone cold yet. Maybe half a day since they left.
Bison's been dead about the same amount of time.
So what do you want to do?
They could still be in the area. Let's get up higher. See if we spot anything. This way. We should have a good view from up here. See anything?
A See some smoke to the east. Maybe another camp. It's worth a look.
All right. Let's go. Bastards. Just killing for fun.
You think we can talk?
I don't kill for fun. I kill when I need to. Shoot those bison.
What's your problem?
I said, did you fools shoot those bison?
Calm down, you black or red bastard, whatever the fuck you are.
Did you shoot them?
Yes, we did. We shot them bison. We'll shoot you too if you don't get.
What business is it of yours? What? We. It's that business of mine!
Good God, you're crazy!
I got a family. A family. Don't shoot me.
Stand back, Charles. I'll get you some answers.
What the hell are you doing?
Why are you killing those bison and leaving them to rot?
I don't know what you're talking about.
God damn it, tell us or you're dead.
Oh, okay. We were paid to kill as many as we could and make it look like it was Indians.
Just kill him, Arthur.
No, please don't kill me.
I've heard enough.
Damn right. That's what he deserved. I've seen enough of this. I'm heading back.
Okay. I'm gonna see if there's anything worth taking from their camp. I'll catch up with you later. There we go.
Thank you.
easy. Now, come on! You're okay, boy. Yeah, good boy.
Whoa! Careful!
Hello, ma'am.
Sir.
I'm too old to get a job, mister. Way too old. Can't we be friends?
Get out of here.
You're not kind, mister. You're not kind at all.
Okay, boy. Let's go.
Come on, sir. Try to remember what really happened at Sylvia's Saloon back in 76.
Just a lot of bunk, Plato. It's just a lot of bunk.
It's not bunk, Mr. Calloway.
Who's your friend,
sir,
there?
Ha! Put that in your fucking book, Plato.
This is Jim Boy Calloway. The Jim Boy Calloway.
Who?
The gunslinger.
fastest left-handed draw that ever drew breath. He once killed 14 men in a fight at Lucy Hollow.
What are you waiting for?
How do you mean?
Well, I reckon right now, kill him yourself.
I don't want to kill him. I want to deify him. He's a god. I'm trying to write his biography.
How's that going?
I think I prefer the duel. Either I'd kill him and be able to be Baltimore's finest ever gunslinger, or he'd kill me and I could be set free from ever having to speak to him again.
Well, you're starting to understand something very important.
What's that?
The joys of gunslinging. It's win-win, freedom or glory.
That's brilliant. I'm gonna write that down, if I may.
Be my guest.
What's your name?
I don't have a name.
But you are a gunslinger.
Not really. I mean, folks who need shooting, I try and shoot in the back. All that other stuff, it's, well, bunk.
But you fought duels.
Once upon a time, I may have.
And you ain't interested in fame?
I don't think so.
Strange. But you like fortune.
I need money, sure.
Okay, then forgive me, mister, if I seem a little desperate. I am a little desperate. This book, I've got to make a thing of it, and, well, there's a whole list of gunfighters, legends, every...
Saddle sore, dog tired.
Well, certainly.
Fine horse there.
Thank you.
Oh, shit.
I'm gonna shoot you down. I will.
All right.
Sir, not a bad little hunt for a beginner.
My God.
Thank you.
Let's get you cleaned up. Boy. Okay, boy.
Hello.
How's things with you?
Better than usual.
Be a dirty rotten thug for what you did to me, but I'll still take your dirty rotten money. Just watch it.
Okay, take a look, but I'm watching you close.
Going to just linger here?
What do you want?
This is private. Get lost.
Okay, partner, whatever you say.
Whoa! What the hell's the gun for? Oh, this ain't over! He's a thief! Stop him!
God, no!
You run real funny.
No, sir.
For God's sake!
This here would be one of Dutch Vandalin's boys, fellas.
That's it! You're dead! Ah!
Let's go!
Oh, and then the leg is coming up. Yeah!
Get clear!
What in the name of all that's holy happened here?
Oh, Moira, don't be like that, please.
How do you want me to be?
Well, I love you.
You don't love anyone. Not me, not your wife, no one.
Oh, you're impossible.
Impossible? Really? I've wasted years on you, and I'm impossible.
You're married, too. You can be impossible.
Impossible? You are a sad little small-town, self-important rat of a man, you know that? A rat. A rat who thinks he's a cat. That's your problem. Go to hell.
Mr. Sheriff.
Hello there.
Let's go, boy.
Yeah, that ought to do her.
I wish they'd hurry up and get on with it.
Enough with the prologue. Let's get to the main act.
I've been done 10 minutes ago and had time to clean my boots.
Ooh, it's gonna happen. Look at them. They're all over each other.
Let's get out of here.
Well, let's see.
I am gloriously fuddled now.
I feel so light and heavy at the same time.
Have I told you what an amazing woman you are?
Oh,
but you are. Let us be free and wild and bad, my dear. Let us make love like love has never been made before. Let me take you to the clouds.
Well, that was pathetic for all of us.
Well, hell, you don't say.
That's it, boy.
Hey, mister.
I can't seem to catch a break today.
Life ain't always easy.
Hello, welcome.
You ugly bastard. You're getting old. Old and kind of sad. No wonder they all leave you. You sour-faced idiot. You ain't fooling no one.
Freshen up a bit. You've got a bathing service. All right, then.
All right, boy. Hey, friend.
Ain't gonna lie. That's a fine old nag you got there.
Come on!
out of the way!
Mister?
Hey now, you've caused just about enough trouble for us.
You don't have to worry about me.
Look, let's not be at loggerheads forever. Stay friendly from now on, all right?
Wait a sec. You can't be over there.
There's nothing for you back there, sir.
This shop ain't the place for your tomfoolery.
What do you want? This is private. Get lost.
This area ain't for customers. Go on now.
Don't worry about it.
Well then.
You draw iron in front of me, you better not use it.
I sound fine without your trouble.
I can't watch you like a hawk forever. You just behave from now on, right?
Hey, that area ain't for you. Come on, act your age in here. Down.
Let me into that back room of yours right now.
Sir, please. You don't want to get involved with them, I promise you.
You make them open up, or you're a dead man.
Hey, open up. It's me. I brought some food and whiskey for you fellas.
Yeah, it's only the doc.
Don't try anything funny.
Thought you were that cowpoke who bothered us earlier.
Looks like a nice little business you got going. yet. Dumb move.
What the hell happened here?
Hey, stand down. Ah! In the air. Shots fired. Frank, you all right?
Easy now. Whoa. Hey, you.
What do you want?
Howdy. You Granger?
That's my name. And my occupation, too, if you hadn't noticed.
Weren't always like that, though, were you? Used to be a quick draw guy. You knew Jim Boy Calloway?
Used to be's correct. Them days are long over. And who might you be?
Don't matter. I need you to tell me about Jim Boy. Just a quote for a book.
A book about Jim Boy? Well, shit. I can't talk to you now. Look at me. I'm knee-deep in hog crap.
Well, don't mind me. We can talk while you work.
I ain't talking and shoveling. Besides, a young man like you could get it done in half the time.
I don't know about that.
What's to know? You interested in the old days? You shovel this shit, I tell you some stories. You keep your hands clean, I don't give you squat.
God damn it. These better be some stories.
Oh, they are. Pick up the fork and get to work. Or get out of here and stop wasting my time.
All right. Shovel your damn shit.
Jim Boy weren't nothing, you know. Me? I killed men, women, and children, too. Animals. I even killed rocks. And I killed them good. I shot folks, stabbed folks, skinned folks. I scalped some. Boy, they scream when you scalp them.
Hey, let me work.
Don't know what got into these hogs, but I know what's coming out of them. I bashed folks, butchered folks. I burned folks alive. Buried folks alive. One time, I...
Yeah, I get it, all right? You're mean. What about Calloway?
You have no idea, girlie. By a feminine type like you, I'd probably have chopped your head off, stuffed you, and eaten you like a sausage.
No doubt.
That's a sloppy one. It's only pig shit, sonny. Get your back into it, boy. You ain't done. Now it's clean enough to eat off.
I guess I'm done.
Get that barrel to the shit pile, and I suppose you is.
All right.
No shortage of shit round here. Comes from hungry hogs and no hands.
Hell, that stinks. Okay, I cleaned up your mess. Go on, tell me about Calloway.
I said I'd tell you stories. I didn't say they'd be about him.
Don't trifle with me, old man. You knew him. Just give me something, anything.
You're making a book, you should make it about me.
They're just words, is all. Give me something to say and I'll leave you alone. You owe me that.
Hey, you be careful. Killer like me, it don't take much to end up on the end of my knife. One
hey,
time...
You know what? I don't think you were anything at all. Just a crazy old man.
I ain't a killer. Well, you'd already be hog feed. I hadn't made a deal with the Federals got this far.
This is your last chance, Mr. Granger. Give me a quote for the book.
Hey, you don't hit no man of peace. No government witness.
Calloway said you was full of piss, but he didn't tell me the half of it.
I'm itching to drop you, girlie. Only you ain't worth my time. I got too much to lose.
Too much to lose? Well, seeing as I cleaned up this pigsty, I figure I'm in my rights to wreck it. Let's see.
You don't want to do that? You walk away right now.
Well, well. All I wanted was a quote.
You don't know who you're trifling with. That's my stick!
You walk away right now.
No. No. No! You did not!
Oh,
took yourself a regular shit shower, Mr. Granger.
Boy, that's real nasty.
You earned yourself a killing. And I'm gonna enjoy it now. Draw! It's gonna be the last thing you do.
You're okay, boy. There we go. There, boy. Shh, boy. Come on. Let's get. Okay there.
Who are you?
Hey.
Hello, chum.
Chum?
Do you want an autograph or a photograph?
I'm sorry?
People often get nervous, but there's really no need.
You ain't welcome at this camp. You don't need to be here. Go away.
I ain't here to cause trouble.
I'm serious.
You don't like visitors, huh?
Thank you.
Yep.
Yep. Easy, boy, you're okay.
Haven't received anything from you in a while, Mr. Morgan.
Yeah, I hear you.
They kidnapped me when I was 12 years old, right from my mama. That's so? Malcolm Foreman. Well, he treated me real bad. He was bad. Know how I slit his throat and ran away? I never felt bad about killing him. I ran back to where my mama was working, but she died. I was falling into trouble. Dutch.
Oh, yes. I'll be able to make you something out of this.
Saved me. Raised me.
Hey, if you could give me some leather working tools, I can make some rugs and blankets and the like out of these hides you're bringing in.
Okay, leave it with me.
I'll need some more materials before I can make something like that. Ah, yes, that'll be much appreciated.
A few changes never hurt.
When are you gonna take
that
bad
job, Morgan? Found this. You said you lost yours.
Oh, it's beautiful. Thank you.
How's it going?
Here, please take this. Oh, it's the least I can do.
Days. Sorry to hear that.
Morning, Arthur.
Those twins who bought the horses are strange, huh?
Real strange. And they don't like Cubans.
You want to sit, Morgan?
All right.
Have a seat by the fire, Arthur.
Good job finding this spot.
You found it, too.
Got a hold of a harmonica for you.
look forward to hearing you play.
The only audience I ever had was my husband, and I'm gonna keep it that way.
Oh, fair enough.
But thank you, Arthur. This is real kind of you.
Arthur.
You going fishing?
Yes.
Or running off to Colm O'Driscoll?
Of course not.
I was joking.
That's very funny. Yes, very funny. I saved your life, and now you torture me. Ho, ho.
Shut up.
Do you want to go fishing with me? I found an interesting spot. We'll do well.
I'm not a great fisherman.
But I am. I'll teach you something. We come?
Sure.
All right, then. Grab your horse and let's go. Hey, what's wrong? What are you doing? Don't tell me you changed your mind. Okay, follow me. I know a great little fishing spot along the beach. Who'd have thought it? Wasn't that long ago I was tied to the back of your horse while begging for mercy.
So, you were saying?
Now we're off fishing.
How do you know? I ain't just looking for a good place to drop. Found you.
Because I saved your life, Arthur.
You keep saying that. But I save your life every day I don't kill you. So we are more than even on that front.
Come on, you don't mean that.
You better believe I mean it. Now, where's this spot?
Not much further. The place. Some beautiful smallmouth here.
Bass?
Sure. This strip of shore looks perfect. Pick a spot. Seeing lots of bluegill and bass over here. Eight. with worms or crickets if you got them. Otherwise, maybe some bread or cheese. There you go. Not too fast. You can break the line. Nice. Good catch, Arthur. Now see if you can hook another. Why aren't you fishing?
You getting many bites there, O'Driscoll?
I ain't an O'Driscoll. I told you fellas 100 times. I'd only been with him a couple of months. I was just a runner, helping out with the horses mainly. Bottom rung of the ladder.
And to think that was the high point of your career.
Comb goes through men like cigars. They ain't like you folks. You barely knew my name. I'm more Kieran Vanderlyn than Kieran O'Driscoll at this point. Honest to God. Mostly I'm Kieran Duffy.
I hate to break it to you, but I ain't sure Kieran Vanderlyn is gonna stick.
What in the world? Arthur, are you seeing this? The feather's naked as a jaybird.
Is that why you like this spot?
My lord, there's somebody who needs to go to confession.
Hey, what's the line?
Oh, hey! I nearly gulped down a minnow. Sorry, fellas. Didn't see you there. Why don't you take a break? Come on in. The water's wonderful. You here for some fishing?
We hope to. You haven't scared them all away, have you?
Oh, just so you fellas know, there's some real big ones over that way, like this. Well, I better keep the blood pumping. Hope you gents catch something.
Yeah? Maybe we'll take a look. Thanks.
I know where that is.
Well,
come on, let's
take
go.
Take care.
Come on, let's go.
Hey, wait up!
Mm-hmm.
I think this is the place that naked feller was talking about. Did you see that amazing bluegill?
Sure. Got you real excited, huh?
Come on, Arthur. Let's walk down to the beach. What are you waiting for? Cast one in then, Arthur. Hope we land this monster.
Uh-huh.
It ain't easy to catch a fish like that with bread and cheese, but you never know. We might get lucky.
Guess we'll see.
Did you hook him, the big one?
I don't know. Don't feel like much of a fighter.
Nope, not the big one. Let's keep trying. So, you think Dutch trusts me now?
That's a good one.
What?
Not in the slightest, my friend.
I can't win. I promised loyalty, he says, but you wasn't loyal to Colm. If I say I ain't got no allegiance to nobody, he says, how do I know you won't turn on us then?
I don't know what you want to hear. I'm trying hard to feel sorry for you, but somehow I just can't manage to.
That has got to be the one, right?
Nah, don't feel very big to me.
No, that's not it. I don't think we have much chance. We need better bait. You might want to see if the stores around here sell anything better. I think I'm gonna head back to camp, Arthur, if that's okay.
Sure. Go on, I'll see you later.
Thank you.
good boy. Yeah, that's it, boy. Yeah. Easy, easy.
I know you think I'm just some effete buffoon.
What?
A man of words and not of action. Hardly a man at all.
Well, I think you're as slippery as an eel in an oil slick, but still a man.
Because I think I've found something interesting.
Yeah?
Have you ever robbed a stagecoach?
No, never. Well, who would have even thought? Of course I robbed a goddamn stagecoach. You know I have.
And what's the problem with stagecoaches?
The armed man attempting to put a bullet in your head?
Not quite. The odds. I mean, is it worth the robbing?
Sometimes.
I know. But, well, if you'd like to come with me, I can introduce you to a new best friend, and he's going to give you all the decent, robbable stagecoaches a hot-blooded degenerate could require.
Well, I could require a whole lot. Where do we find this friend of yours?
Rhodes.
Because what can possibly go wrong there?
Well, lead the way and we'll find out.
You sure seem to have got about around here.
You know me. I like to make friends in low places.
How the hell you end up down here anyway?
I could ask the same of you. I have a few commitments over this way. Some expenses to meet.
Expenses? What expenses? Gentlemen's canes and rabbits to pull out of hats?
Among other things, I had quite a nice little business going for a while. Shares in a gold mining company. Excellent returns for the investor of a certain financial standing. Until, well, that unfortunate run-in with the law.
Yeah, that's how it goes. Thanks for disappearing on us during that Sean business, by the way.
I've done my part. Each to their strengths, dear boy. You know, you boys should really watch yourselves with those two families. This is a small town. People talk. I tried to mention it to Osea, but you know how he is. Anyway, while they're off chasing their pot of Confederate gold hidden at the end of some rainbow, let me present you with something real.
So, where exactly are we going?
Here we are. We can hitch up outside. I'll make the introductions, Arthur. Come on. Hang back a bit and let me do the talking. We don't want to scare him off. Walden.
Hello, Josiah. How have you been?
Dandy. And you, friend?
Like I said, times are tough. My missus is a bad woman. Terrible woman.
They often are. But how's work, Alden?
Terrible. Wages got cut again. They reckon they just invented a new horse's carriage will be the end of us.
They've been saying that nonsense since they invented the wheel. The wickedness of bosses.
I know. My comrades here and I are greatly discouraged from the adequate fulfillment of our duty.
A discouraged man is no man at all, Alden. No man at all. My friend Arthur here has a present for you.
Did you hear about that gunfight out in the cornfield by Braithwaite Manor?
Here.
Ain't you kind, sir?
Call him Arthur. He's one of us, a fellow man of distinction.
Okay. Well, this is perfect timing. I think you'll like this one, Josiah. It'll be coming south down the river road through Siltwater Strand.
Thank you, Alden. Thank you very much.
Oh, and Josiah, if you or Arthur are ever out Strawberry Way, ask for my colleague there, a feller called Hector. He's also one of the, what did you call us again?
Discouraged men, Alden.
That's it, discouraged men. I like that.
Well, goodbye, Alden, or should I say... adieu.
Oh, adieu, Josiah.
What the hell was that?
I thought you might like to see that boy of mine.
River road through Siltwater Strand, he said.
Okay. I think I know a good spot to wait. Follow me. Okay, let's go. This way. Yeah! Workers are in on it these days, earning a pittance. The unions are whipping them up, so they want something on the side. Like he said, there, Strawberry. Could create a lot of opportunities for a man in your line of work.
I ain't sure about going back to Strawberry after all that market business.
Didn't sound like you left anyone alive to recognize you, so I wouldn't worry too much, dear boy. All this trouble. You gentlemen are becoming quite the celebrities, aren't you? Soon you'll be on the front of a dime novel. And dead, of course.
We're hoping to be long gone before that. Dutch has a plan.
Whoa, now. Here we are. This is the spot. Okay, this should do.
Sure. Here.
I'm hoping we won't need those.
Better safe than sorry. So what were you thinking?
Well, according to this, the loot is located in a strong box, which is in the back. I'll put on a little performance, and you can scurry around, open the strong box, and relieve them of their goodies.
And how do I open the strong box without threatening someone to open it for me?
This should work.
And I can do this silently?
Well, I'm hoping complete silence won't be necessary. But you're going to wish you had your earplugs. This is Damson. Oh, very good, Alden, very good. Of course, if anything goes wrong, you can wave your guns around like you normally do. Hold tight. They'll be here soon. There it is. Right on time. Let's go. Keep your distance so they don't see you. And please leave that gun in its holster for once. Mm-hmm. right ahead and get the coach to stop. You hang back. Don't let them spot you or you'll scupper the whole thing. I hope you don't mind my singing.
Not at all.
I'm preparing for a show.
It's a free country.
Did you say a show?
It's a small benefit. Build up with Blackwater. Just
Mrs. Chester Damson.
I flatter nobody.
Stop the coach, my good man! Stop the coach!
Whoa! Miss Damson, why did you stop singing?
The New York audience, they were rather cruel.
New Yorkers are prigs and fools who believe Westerners don't know anything about culture.
I couldn't agree more.
Could you? It's such a small show, but would you sing something for me? I'm looking for a mezzo-soprano.
I don't know.
Miss Damson, you owe it to West Elizabeth. I've heard enough. Might I have your card? The event is on the 23rd of this month. I can't say enough about Mrs. Damson. Magnifico. So sorry, gentlemen, for the interruption. Farewell. Well done, sir. Well done.
It was easy. You did all the work.
Teamwork, my dear boy. Teamwork.
Here you go.
Thank you. Oh, jolly good. Go see Alden from time to time. See you soon, Arthur.
Got any more opera singers for me to rob?
How are you, Arthur?
Yep! Oh!